Well, here at Malmstrom, the helicopter provides security for the missile fields and rapid response in case anything were to happen. We also support the missile field in general. Being able to take people out to the field in a timely manner is a pretty huge thing, especially when the weather's real bad, which here in Montana, it can get pretty bad. So helicopters are pretty amazing machines. They were developed first in the 1930s and mass-produced in the 1940s during World War II. And they are essentially airfoils that spin around in a circle. So take your typical airplane wing, put two on top of this helicopter in particular, and spin it around at a fast enough speed, and that'll generate lift. And then there's a bunch of other aerodynamic principles that you need to understand in order to fly a helicopter successfully as a pilot, and certainly were important in developing the helicopter. A helicopter generates lift by spinning the rotor system at a particular speed. For the Huey, it's around 320 RPM, rotations per minute, and that speed is constant. It's maintained during the entire time the aircraft is flying, and as we pull in pitch or collective, it collectively changes the pitch in the blade, so increases the angle of attack on the blades. That creates lift and pushes the helicopter up. So there are three controls in a helicopter that control flight: the cyclic, the collective, and the tail rotor pedals. With the cyclic, that's how we control our front, aft, left, right control of the helicopter. The collective collectively changes the pitch in the blade, so that's how we go up and down or add power and decrease power. And then the pedals, the anti-torque pedals, are what control the swing of the tail in a hover or the yaw of the aircraft. There is a horizontal stabilizer in the tail boom section of the helicopter, and it's actually really cool if you look at it because it's an upside down airfoil, it's an upside down wing. And the reason is because in forward flight, we actually use that to put force on the tail boom so that the helicopter flies more in a level attitude. So it's really cool when you look at it, it looks like an upside down wing, and the pitch of that actually changes with moving the cyclic forward and aft. Drag definitely is a pretty big factor in how a helicopter flies. The body itself produces drag as you're traveling through the relative wind. And also the blades themselves, both the main rotor system and the tail rotor system, create drag as a byproduct of creating lift. Probably one of the coolest things about flying a helicopter is all the aerodynamic effects behind it. So the tail rotor is doing a lot of things, the main rotor is doing a lot of things, and when the rotor's spinning, it's actually a disc. We stop thinking about it as two individual rotor blades and we think about it as a rotor disc. With a helicopter main rotor system, in order to fly forward, you have to increase the angle of attack on the left side of the disc, the spinning rotor disc, so that the force generates lift in the back of the rotor disc in order to push the aircraft forward. So I always think that's a pretty cool principle of flying a helicopter, really thinking about where and what is going on with all the aerodynamics in the main rotor system and the tail rotor system.